The folks behind the Cosmic Shimmer brand continue to produce really nice products, and the newest, Pixie Bursts, are the focus of today's video. As you'll see, the colors are vivid and there's a whole lot of creative fun to be had with them, especially when you combine them with other media or use them in not-so-traditional applications. Best of all is that we've got them on introductory sale and they're discounted by 20%. You'll find links down below, and don't forget that we'll discount your shipping if you spend $50 or more on products other than gift certificates. Let's begin with the basics about Pixie Bursts. These are dye powder without any shimmer, so you're going to see bursts of color only. Now, from a big picture perspective, a dye powder is meant to dye something an end color, and in order to achieve whatever that final color is supposed to be, it's going to combine one or more other colors, and each of those colors typically is going to be made of individual color bits. So when you look at the swatches that I've got going on here, even though this is named Cut Grass, you can see that there's some yellow in here, there's some blue in here, because yellow and blue make green. So you're going to always see those separate colors. If you add a little water, they're going to stay more distinct. If you add more water, everything is going to mix together to create whatever that final color is supposed to be. Now, with that said, dye colors are translucent and are going to be visible on most surfaces. Now, you're not going to see them on black, because if something is translucent on black, all you see is black. But here's Craft, and I've got Very Berry and Making Waves. And in fact, they are a little bit different than what you'd see on the white, but they certainly work, and that is true for pretty much any other color other than black. So the initial release includes 10 colors, and you can intermix them for a larger palette. You just want to keep in mind the color wheel so that you don't make mud. Now, I swatched all of them. I mean, it only took half an hour, if it even took that long, to swatch all 10. I think it's important to see what you're going to get before you add the water to whatever you've sprinkled on. And you know, dye powder can be deceiving. This doesn't look like very much in here, but ultimately is going to be black cherry, which is what this is. And that kind of runs across the gamut of colors. What you see here is not necessarily what you're going to see when you add water. So let's talk about what those colors are. In alphabetical order, you have Black Cherry, Cut Grass, Firefly Glow, Green Jasper, Making Waves, Orange Slice, Purple Orchid, Rusty Red, Very Berry, and Wild Moss. Now, with that said, these have all been opened. Let's move these out of the way. But when you take the cap off the very first time, you're going to see a piece that's covering like this. It's just the inner seal. You'll want to remove that and then go ahead and put it in the trash. You put your whole cap assembly back on, and then when you're ready to use it, you just pop this off and you're good to go. So with that said, what happens if you feel like a little bit of shimmer? Because, you know, shimmer is a good thing. We all love shimmer. The simplest thing that you can do is add Pixie Sparkles. There are 26 colors in that line, and with those 26 and these 10, you can play Mad Scientist to your heart's content for all kinds of fun combinations. So, like any other powdered media, you can sprinkle Pixie Bursts either on a wet surface and or sprinkle them on a dry surface and add water. So I'm going to do both ways here for you. I've got, these are 3x4 Joggles disc-bound watercolor pages. What is this color? This is Orange Slice. So we'll start by putting some water on here. Now there's a little speck of something on there, which is why the color bloomed. And you can see the blooming that happens. Conversely, if I want to put the powder on a dry surface and then go ahead, I can get a little bit more control this way. I can see how much bleeding and melding of the individual dye colors I'm going to get. I can do more here, I can do more here, but I think my control is a little bit better here. So typically when I do this, I'm going to put the powder on and then I'm going to apply water after the fact. All right, so we don't need to let these dry. I'm just going to get them out of the way here for 1 second and then mop up what's on my surface. You know, a moment ago I mentioned what happens if you feel like you need some sparkle, because there are days when you just need some sparkle. So what I did was, as I said, I pulled in the Pixie Sparkles. So this is Rusty Red. Let me find the Rusty Red sample. That one is Wild Moss. All right, so we're going to need this. And here's Rusty Red. So this is Rusty Red and the Pixie Sparkle color that's named Fuchsia Rose. And you can see, not only can you see all that glimmer on there when the light hits it just right, but you can see that because there's dye color in the Pixie Sparkles too, it's going to change what's going on here. Here's the one that I did. This is Wild Moss and Green Bay. Green Bay is the Pixie Sparkle color, and you can see all that shimmer on there. And you can see that there's a little bit more blue here than there is in Wild Moss. These happen to be pretty close. These were a little bit further apart. So what I'm going to do now is take one of my 3x4 pages, and I have the Pixie Sparkle color named Gilded Plum, and I'm going to combine that with Purple Orchid as soon as I can find the Purple Orchid. 10 colors, and you know it's going to be the last one I pick up. Sure enough. Okay, here we go. So this is Purple Orchid. When I do this, I like to put the Pixie Burst on first so that the shimmer from the Pixie Sparkle is on top. I mean, ultimately, it's all going to get wet anyway, but that's just the way that I happen to be doing it. All right. If you find that you get so much of the powder up into the tip of this bottle and you're not really getting very much coming out, go ahead and just tap the bottle like that. All right. So now we're going to come in. That's Purple Orchid. Now we're going to come in with Gilded Plum. So Purple Orchid, if I bring this out, you can see it's a pretty darn blue purple. It's one, though you can see lighter colors in here, ultimately the final color of this ends up being a pretty blue purple. On the other hand, Gilded Plum is a much pinker purple. It's more like a magenta. So here comes the fun. I'm going to go ahead and mist this. And you can already see the difference. Obviously, you won't see this until it dries. I can't show you the shimmer until it dries, but here's a sample that I did using these same two colors. And if I hold this so that the light can reflect on it, you can see the sparkles in the background. And certainly, this is a much different color, final color that results from combining the two than you would get with the more blue of the Purple Orchid. So up next, I'm going to bring in some alternate surfaces, deli paper and dictionary paper, and wait till you see how much fun we're going to have with them. Deli paper is a pretty interesting surface to work on, and very often you'll see people tear it up for collage. Now, typically when you use it for a collage, any deli paper, whether it's printed or colored in some way, you're going to apply it with gel medium. You would put the gel medium on the surface, put the torn deli paper on top of the wet gel medium, and then add another coat of gel medium on top, and that kind of seals it all in place. Now, with that said, because Pixie Bursts are not permanent, if you do that with deli paper that has Pixie Bursts on it, the color is going to reactivate the moment it comes in contact with the gel medium. So if you can imagine brushing gel medium on, you'll pick up the colors and you're going to spread it around and you're not going to maintain this pattern. So the workaround is to use a gel plate and print a layer of gel medium on top to seal it in place. First, let's start. I'm going to show you, this you sprinkle, you add water. I'm going to show you how to do this, which is kind of a fun way. It's an interesting technique. So our deli paper comes folded in half, and when you look at it, one side is matte. That's the side where the fold is pointing down, and the other side has a little bit of gloss to it. That's the side where this is more like a mountain. So I'm going to turn this over this way, and when I do this, I'm going to apply just Pixie Burst and water to one side, and that'll make sense in a second. So I have Firefly Glow and Making Waves. All I'm going to do is put some on both sides of the deli paper, on one side of the deli paper. Ultimately, both sides will be colored, but you'll see how that works in a second. All right, that's enough of the Firefly Glow. So in now comes Making Waves. Okay, here comes some water. Now, the thing to know is that even though this side is a little bit glossy, the water will eventually bleed through this. You'll see my hands get colored. So here comes the water, and this looks cool, but if I take this and fold this in half, and then I smear it like this, I can push the color, the liquid that has now activated the color around in such a way that when I open this up, it almost looks like a Rorschach print. I think that this is really fun. All right, so let's open this up. Let me grab a piece of paper towel and just kind of mop up the mess. Now, with that said, obviously I can't do anything until this is dry, but I think that this is such a cool technique. In fact, this almost reminds me of a butterfly. If this is the butterfly body right here, I almost have this wing pattern going. Now, I probably wouldn't use it in a large piece like that, but that's what I see when I look at it, and I'm certain that somebody would want to psychoanalyze that and come up with some weird statement about my personality, but such is the way of things. So I'm going to move this out of the way because I have one that's already dry. And I want to show you. So here is the one that's already dry. Now, when you look at the Firefly Glow, it's got multiple colors in it, which is, they all do. But it's got this little tiny bit of orange that popped up here and there. It just is. You never know exactly what you're going to get. All right, so the way to do this, I'm going to bring in my 12 by 12 gel press plate. And the reason I'm using 12 by 12 is because a piece of our deli paper fits on here pretty darn well. Okay, so if I were to wet this, this would immediately reactivate. What I'm going to do instead, this is Dina's, this is just happens to be one of the little squeezy bottles. It's 1 ounce of her gel medium. So I'm going to get some of this on the plate. Now, I will be able to pull a ghost print from this, if you will. How much you see really is a function of how much dye was on here, how much pixie burst, how much you put down here. And as you play, you'll kind of get the hang of that. But if you don't get a magnificent ghost print, it doesn't really matter. You're going to tear it up for collage anyway. All right, so there's that. I'm going to take this and put this face down in here now. And you can see that I can get all of this done because it fits on that 12 by 12 plate. Now, with that said, some of the color will activate because it's coming in contact with wet, but there's really no other way to do this that I can think of. So I can see now that I've got gel medium pretty much everywhere it needs to be. So I'm going to pick this up, and yes, there is color left, and because I put a little bit of a heavy coat of gel medium down, so you can see it on here, it really hasn't changed the pattern all that much. It's just going to seal it in once the gel medium dries. All right, so that's out of the way. Let me grab another piece of deli paper, and I'm going to put this, well, that one's already got some color on it. Let's take one that doesn't. I'm going to put this face down in here. Now, like always, you'll want to move reasonably quickly so stuff doesn't dry before you have a chance to print that ghost print. All right, so that looks pretty good. There's some creases in there that just makes for more interesting stuff. And here is my ghost print. Now, I could probably print this more if I wanted to, but I'm not going to take the time to do that. I'm just going to spritz my brayer, move it out of the way so that the gel medium doesn't dry, and then I'm going to quickly spritz this and just wipe it off. And then I'm going to move on. I want to show you how this stuff works on dictionary pages. The thing to remember is that because dyes are transparent and because pixie bursts are dyes, I'm going to get transparent color, which means I'm going to be able to see the text underneath. So this is the dictionary pages that we sell, and I have two more colors. I have Rusty Red and Berry Berry. I figured I'd switch from cool to warm. So again, I'm just going to go ahead and sprinkle these on here. And if I want to get a little crazy, and I want to bring back some of the Gilded Plum because I know that will work, so that way I get some shimmer along with my color. And because I'm on that warm side of the color wheel, I know I'm not going to make mud. I can go ahead and let's see what kind of fun combination this ends up being. Now, dictionary paper is pretty lightweight, so you're not going to want to oversaturate this with water. And the situation here will be exactly the same as it was a moment ago with the deli paper. If I want to be able to collage this with gel medium in place, then I've got to go ahead and print it like I just did on the gel press plate, so that the matte medium, the gel medium seals it in place. Oh, how pretty is that? Now, if I've got a lot of dye going on, then I am going to some extent, I'm going to change the value that you can see here, so I can sop some of this up, and now the text will be a little bit more apparent. So this, as I said, is really thin. This is going to need to be set to one side to dry, but I can already see that there's kind of a gold-colored mica in the Gilded Plum Pixie Sparkle, so that's going to look really cool when it's done. So these are, let's kind of wipe this mess up because we just got a big one going here. These are the new Cosmic Shimmer I knew I was going to do that at least once. These are the new Cosmic Shimmer Pixie Bursts. These are 10 colors on introductory sale here at joggles.com. And we've got them all in stock, and they are ready to go to your house to have some fun playing with you.